Well, Mondo, this is really...
It's been a wonderful trip, hasn't it, so far? Kind of everything I expected it to be and more.
Footer. See Ruth coming out there on the bow. Got two other.
These are all the boats that have come in from all parts of the world and have harbor fever sitting here waiting to go out again. It's the middle of the ocean stopping off point, and a lot of people just stop off here for good and don't really want to leave. It's sometimes tough out there, and they've been through some tough times, and the harbor looks really comfortable. Take it down somewhere and then Pacific to group or something. It's raining. Our guide says that this is not fog or smog or haze, but it actually is volcanic dust coming from the big island 200 miles away. And it's pulling forth its ash and gases. Along the beach right off of Diamond Head. A guide saying one bedroom, one bath, one car stall cost anywhere from $250 up for Diamond Head. Fairly heavy seas right around the corner here between the two islands. I guess the wind comes from 25 knots to 40 knots out here. That means 4 or 5 inch seas.
There's a submarine that comes up.
I can see the hull coming up.
Passenger
rod. We're sailing into the marina at about 20 knots.
Not quite.
All right, 20 knot wind. Here we are in Samoa. This is the fifth day of our trip. We're finally got off the island of Hawaii. And this is our hotel. It's called a Rainmaker Hotel. It's a quaint little place. And they go inside the hotel. Really typical of the busy port of Pango Pango. Places, the roofs of all these places are shaped upside down boat. Really unique structures. The inside is like the ribs of a boat, upside down. I think most of the cars don't bother to have license plates on them. Some of them might have a temporary permit, but this is a lagoon very early in the morning, right outside of our hotel window. And this is about maybe 10 feet from our room. And someday I would love to come back here in my own boat. It's a long way from there to here. Across a lot of open water. Oh, to learn. Enough to do it. Looks like this tree was gonna fall over, so they fixed it. This is the purse seining fish facility in Samoa. What they do is they run this over there and snag the fish up. They let them to purse seine capital of the Pacific. Right above the mouth of Samoa. This is the big city of government buildings. This is where we're going to anchor our boat when we come in. Pango Pango, American Samoa, for the natives, the skirt. Their feet. They have these burial grounds here, right out in front of the house, and the guy riding on a bucket. Here's my traveling companion on my bus ride. It was a pleasure. But he says people can put whoever they want in their front lawn. It's their property and they can do what they want with it.
In the afternoon, it was raining just about an hour ago. It's cleared up now and the fog started to rise up again over the hills. It come down halfway down the hill while it was raining, wind blowing. An hour later, sun's out and clearing up again.
You just see it rising off the hill there. Right closer.
So now we're about to take another bus ride to the other end of the island.
Months after a big hurricane came through here, and some of these houses are pretty well destroyed. Don't say that. Samoan, really. This is after the hurricane. Still recovering. Absolutely beautiful scenery. This is a little store they have in the village here. And like Margo said, they got Clever Girl baking sauce. You hadn't seen that in years. Tough getting up that hill. It's our friends patiently waiting. It's Marvin's and there's Luigi. Very patient people. Got it. Oh, to see how they're doing it, there's not a nail in it. Bring it closer. Very closely, you'll see that it's all flashing. If you look up here at the roof here, there are these pegs lashed to the main beams. Yeah, get on the boat yet. Actually, it's been a very pleasant experience. We've enjoyed the side trips. It's been something we wouldn't have experienced without this interruption. It's been a most pleasant interlude, unexpected.
We have a typical construction work going on at the airport. Ruth is sitting there watching. And she might try this trade later. All handmade joints that would be fitted up here. As soon as the carving tradesmen here are through with their chore, chop away, make the joint. She wants to take a picture.
Airport.
Yep. The international airport.
Bavavu.
Coming in. It's a local duty-free truck that gets smaller shops as you go along.
We arrive in Tonga. It's the mooring. This is the moorings dock. Looks like a Benico sitting out there.
Nice sunny weather until last night.
Yeah, right. Beautiful.
More of them sitting out there.
Yeah. Do you feel like having lunch at the hotel? Or away with the westerly wind flow? So I think as soon as it moves further south, we'll go back to trade with. Should be in a day or so. Ready up.
Hey, bye bye. Reporting our cyclone. Here we are on the Kingdom of Tonga. We're on a lead boat. And the skippers on these boats. We're going to have a skippers meeting this morning. These are moorings boats. The skippers on these boats are here at our meeting. See, we're in the middle of a cyclone. They're sitting here, the skippers deciding what it is they want to do. They're 50 knot winds. The cyclone is reaching 75 knots over near Fiji, moving northwest toward us. So that's really exciting.
Some clown in an office someplace goes like this and says, okay, it's here. And an hour later, it might be 60 miles away.
Very cool. On the AM radio?
Yeah, well, they do that sort of nonsense too.
all decided to stay.
Well, we're waiting for Clayton to get up and
shoot. Skipper's going home now.
Yeah.
Well,
he's taking airline
coral gardens in there?
Oh, just beautiful. So, angelfish, bright yellow ones with black markings on them.
Uh-huh.
And a really cute one with a gray front, a white stripe, black back, and then a little yellow tail.
Very little yellow tail.
Yeah.
I think I've seen those around. They almost got cheated on tail, didn't they?
Yeah. You could say that.
Black coral.
Closer to the beach, I saw lots of gray coral.
Yeah.
And big sea urchins like this big with long spikes like porcupine.
Really? That big?
Yeah, this big. I'm not kidding. I'm not kidding. And they're kind of nestled in the coral, and then there are little teeny fish that kind of insinuate their way into the spines and hide in.
Yeah, here comes Betsy Holman.
There's 1 foot.
They don't swim so well with 1 foot. In a camera?
No, they don't.
Yeah.
You have to learn how to use them.
Bobby by the big birds to keep them.
But anyway, now they specifically allow these exotic birds.
It's probably used when they come over here for your big copra. Until they drop, sometimes they rot.
Other way, Betsy, that's right. Yeah. Goes right back.
Try
to this over here is just the village. So.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, it's up there. Like the Portalaise, which I absolutely love. It's really nice.
There's some
bare
body down there now.
Is there?
Yeah. Oh,
I didn't know that. Was it American companies or?
I'm not sure. I've just seen the first
Make a land.